Hello friends, welcome to Dezinlife. Friends, in this series of Indian pharma business, today we are going to discuss about changing trends of pharmacies in India, or we can say changing role or process of RCPA in Indian pharma business. Friends, traditionally there has been a process of doing RCPA or retail call prescription audit before making personal call to the doctors to persuade him to prescribe our brands or our products. See, there has been time when doctor used to prescribe prescription and the prescription used to go to different pharmacies or different medical store across the cities or even to other cities or nearby cities also. But there has been consistent changes in the pharmacy pattern in Indian pharma, and it has affected the way doctor prescribe product now or doctor prescribe brands now. So we also need to take cognizance of this and need to rethink about the whole process now. To proceed further, I have first divided different kind of pharmacies in India now in 7 different category. Now let us look at which are different 7 kind of pharmacies are active or contributing to Indian pharma now, which if you look at say 20-30 year back, it was primarily one kind of pharmacy, maybe two. So today if you look at out of these 7, the first kind of pharmacy is that in last few years, government has started giving more and more product from the government hospital. So government inside pharmacy, which used to exist earlier also, but with very few products, now it has increased and it is also a force. The second kind of pharmacy is the Jan Aushadhi or the Amrit pharmacy, which are either inside the hospital, government hospital, or inside their campus of the hospital, or we can say close by, which are primarily dispensing generic medicines or the economical medicines. And friends, third category of pharmacy are those pharmacy which are the inside in the private hospital, corporate hospital or nursing home, and lot of patient they are catering, because when patient goes for consultation, they normally tend to buy from inside pharmacy, and when the patients are admitted there, that time also almost all the medicine goes from there. So they are also making a bulk of the contribution. In the past 20-30 years back, because number of private or corporate hospital was less, so they were not so major force, but with the emergence of private hospital, this pharmacy trend is also emerging and contributing big way. The fourth category is attached or close to pharmacies, to the hospitals or to nursing home, or maybe they are close by to them, or even to private doctors. Many of the private doctors in different specialty, they have attached chemist or attached pharmacy with them, and this chunk is also contributed big way, which was not existing, you know, almost 20 years back. The fifth category of pharmacy, which is emergence of recent one, is the pharmacy chain. One pharmacy has got multiple medical store, like Apollo Pharmacy has got almost 4,000 medical shops. Wellness Forever has got huge network in the Maharashtra. There is a Guardian Pharmacy there, the NetMeds are there. So different pharmacy in different cities, or some are across the cities, across the country also. But they are the emerging as a big contributor. And the sixth kind of pharmacy, which is emergence, a recent one probably, that is online pharmacy, like 1MG is there, MedPlus is there, and they are also making good chunk of business, friends. Currently, they may be contributing maybe around 3-4% in a pharma industry, but they are growing by 70-80%. So that is again coming up very fast. And the seventh, the last category, I'll say, there's something we saw traditional pharmacies, or we say brick and mortar pharmacies, or something, you know, kind of pharmacy we have grown up with them. Now, when we look at these 7 kind of pharmacies, the first 6 kind of pharmacies are growing at the cost of 7th kind of pharmacy. Means all first 6 pharmacies are growing better as compared to 7th, because 7th was something traditional, something old one, so they are growing at the cost of that. Now, the traditional pharmacies, they have been trying to remain viable by different ways. Sometimes they do the strike against e-pharmacy, sometimes they do the strike against, say, corporate hospital pharmacies, or you know, purchasing by them. Sometime they try to remain viable by selling or storing generic medicines. Many of them are doing now. And sometime they want to remain viable, or they try to remain viable to passing on as good a 10-15% discount to their customer, so that this customer remain loyal to them. And lastly, they try to remain viable by selling general products, whether it's cosmetics, whether it's a toothpaste, whether hair oil, etc. But these kind of pharmacies are under pressure to remain viable. Friends, there is a saying that you can't stop an idea whose time has come. So now the situation is that the things are shifting to first six type, and it is something unstoppable. Or can say very difficult to stop. So this is something idea where time has come. My purpose of talking here, when this shift is happening and happening at a very fast pace, pharma industry has to take an informed decision or cognizance of this development on two major counts. The first count is the business count, and second count is a count of doing RCPA. When look at say first business count, although I'm not saying that industry is simply not acting on that, but I believe industry need to do more by accepting these realities. When real situation is that first six kind of pharmacies and business done by them is growing, then it should be part of our business model that how we are going to deal with these six categories of the pharmacies or the dispensing. Neglecting them or staying aloof or any behaving ignorant will only harm us. So it's always better to accept the reality and make the required change in our business model. And when I talk of the second count, that is count is RCPA. Not only RCPA, but how we make the product available and how we plan the visit of the pharmacies. With this trend, the way of doing RCPA, the way of making product available, you know, is tend to change. Overall, the place of pharmacies in our business model is tend to change. So we need to accept the change, and we should, you know, start working in new way. That is, how to do a RCPA in the new such situation, because it is not possible the old way. How to make product available in the new setup, because it's no longer the way it was doing, it is not working. So we can say that we need to reposition the place of pharmacies in our business model. So friends, to conclude, we can no longer treat the pharma, or we can no longer treat the pharmacies the way we were treating them, or we have been treating them now. Companies need to rethink on their pharmacy strategy. I'm not talking of here how and what should be done, as it is different organization, their decision, their part of their business model, their strategies. But I'm certainly emphasizing that we need to take cognizance of this factor while making our business model or our customized strategy. So friends, I'm sure with this video, this will help you to, or this will compel you to think about what is your strategy about different pharmacies pattern which is emerging, or what is your thinking about different way of doing RCPA or making a product available. I hope this video will be useful to you. Thank you very much for watching us today. Thank you, friends.